In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hear this reading from the prophet Amos, chapter 5. Alas for you who desire the day of the Lord. Why do you want the day of the Lord? It is darkness, not light, as if someone fled from a lion and was met by a bear, or went into the house and rested a hand against the wall and was bitten by a snake. Is not the day of the Lord darkness, not light, and gloom with no brightness in it? I despise your festivals, and I take no delight in your solemn assemblies. Even though you offer me your burnt offerings and grain offerings, I will not accept them. And the offerings of well-being of your fatted animals, I will not look upon it. Take away from me the noise of your songs. I will not listen to the melody of your harps. But let justice roll down like waters, and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. The Word of the Lord.
Hear the Gospel from the 25th chapter of Matthew. Jesus said to the disciples, "Then the kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. When the foolish took their lamps, they took no oil with them. But the wise took flasks of oil with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, all of them became drowsy and slept. But at midnight there was a shout, 'Look! Here comes the bridegroom, come out and meet him.' Then all those bridesmaids got up, trimmed their lamps, The foolish said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise replied, "No, there will not be enough for you and for us. You had better go to the dealers and buy some for yourself." And while they went to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went with him into the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later, the other bridesmaids came also saying, "Lord, Lord, open to us." But he replied, "Truly I tell you, I do not know you. Keep awake, therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour." This is the gospel of our Lord.
The words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be pleasing to you, O Lord God. Amen. Let me start this sermon out by saying I am recording it Tuesday morning at 10:45. Yes, it's election day, but we don't know what has happened when I am recording this sermon. And we don't know what has occurred Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. I am saying this to you because the texts that the Revised Common Lectionary has for us today are difficult texts. And they're difficult texts, especially in light of the fact that we are going through an election. We are a divided nation. We are a nation that is pointing fingers. We are a nation that is hurting. And here comes the Revised Common Lectionary with scriptures that were picked in the 90s is when, 80s or 90s is when the Revised Common Lectionary was set. 3-year cycle, same scriptures. It doesn't change. It's funny how the Spirit moves though, right? We get this text, we get these texts, the gospel text that points us and calls us to always be ready, always be anticipating, and I think in many ways calls us to be participating in bringing about the kingdom while we are waiting. And also says that we are going to fail miserably. Thankfully, we have a God that says, "That's okay, I still love you. I'm still here with you. I'm gonna pick you up, dust you off, and we're gonna try it again." Because we are always living in response to the grace that we have been given. But what do we make of the prophet Amos? I'll admit, Amos for me, and very few people I think say this openly at least, especially pastors, I love this section of Amos because it's a reality check, right? It was a reality check for the people of Israel when the prophet came about saying it, and it should be a reality check for us today. Amos shows up and tells God's people that God despises their worship, their singing, their offerings, their sacrifices, despises them. And why does God despise them? Because God's people are failing when it comes to seeking righteousness and justice. Those are two big words for us, for the Bible. It's throughout the Bible. This is one of the many texts that deals with it. This is a text that leaders like Martin Luther King Jr., the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.,
used a lot. It's the scripture. You see right back here. That is on this stool. It was one of the first stools I was given. Let justice cover the earth. Let it flow like a river. But what does justice mean? What is the biblical understanding of justice? Here's a hint. It's not what we so often think of. First, to understand justice, we must understand that God has created us all in God's image. And because God has created us all in God's image, we are all equal. And we should be treating each other as equal. We should be seeing each other, each and every person we come in contact with. We should look at and see the image of God, the divine creator. Unfortunately, because of our fallen nature, because of the sinful nature that we have, we often set or maybe redefine and seek after things that are for our own advantage, that will make things better for us. Even Paul talks about being focused on the self is something he doesn't want to do, but does. And understands, Paul understands that that is part of our problem. Part of the issue that stems from the fall and our fallen nature. Now, righteousness and justice so often go hand in hand. Righteousness, when we look at the Bible, especially the Old Testament, righteousness is seen as an ethical standard. Ethical standard. System. Ethical rubric for some that you might want to use. Of treating people as if they are the image of God, like we are called to do. So it's this way of doing what we are called to do and truly, at least trying to see people as the image of God. And we fail at that a lot. But we should keep trying. We should keep seeking that righteousness. Justice kind of stems from that idea of righteousness. Because justice usually in the Bible is referencing what's called kind of restorative, uplifting justice. A justice that seeks out the disadvantaged and lifts them up to be equals. Sometimes when we lift people up, we must lower ourselves, just like God came down from heaven to be with us. You see how that works? If we are Christians and we believe in a God descendant in the person of Jesus, if we follow Jesus' model, we must do the same. We must lift people up even when, or especially when, it means that we must lower ourselves. That's a hard truth. But let's take a look at just three verses. Three verses in the Bible that outline justice. We're going to stay in the Old Testament because the Old Testament, that's where Amos is. So let's stay in that world. We're going to look at Psalm 146, verses 7 through 9. Actually, let's go up to 5 through 9. Happy are those whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord their God. Okay, we got that, right? the God who made heaven and earth, the sea and all that is in them, who keeps faith forever, who executes justice for the oppressed, who gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets the prisoners free. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord watches over the strangers. He upholds the orphan and the widow. But the way of the wicked, he brings to ruin. So God, that's the image of justice that God loves. Justice for the oppressed, food for the hungry, setting the captive free, opening the eyes of the blind, lifting up those that are bowed down, those that are at a lower level in society. The Lord watches over the strangers. So if we are following the way of the Lord, if we're following the way of God, because happier are those whose help is in the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord, their God. Following that example, that's what we're called to do. Let's flip over to Proverbs. Great book, right? Great book of short, precise sayings that should help us guide our lives. Proverbs 31, 8 and 9. What does that say? Speak out for those who cannot speak, for the rights of the destitute. Now that can also be translated as for the rights of all. Speak out, judge righteously, defend the rights of the poor and needy. Oh, speak out for those who cannot speak, for the rights of all the destitute. Speak out, judge righteously, defend the rights of the poor and the needy. We continue into the prophet Jeremiah, chapter 22, verse 3. Thus says the Lord, act with justice and righteousness, and deliver from the hand of the oppressor anyone who has been robbed, and do no wrong or violence to the alien, also can be translated as the immigrant, the sojourner, the orphan, and the widow, or shed innocent blood in this place. For if you will indeed obey this word, then through the gates of this house shall enter kings who sit on the throne of David. Act with justice and righteousness, and deliver from the hand of the oppressor anyone who has been robbed, and do no wrong or violence to the alien, the orphan, and the widow, or shed innocent blood in this place. Those are hard, right? Jesus picks up this line of thinking, because Jesus, again, what does Jesus say? The law that we just read some of, and the prophets that we are dealing with, Jeremiah and Amos, prophets, The law and all the prophets hang on these two things: to love God and to love our neighbors as ourselves. If we see ourselves as the image of God, to see and to love our neighbor means to see them also as the image of God, and to fight for, to do justice and righteousness for them. And remember when Jesus is asked, "Who is my neighbor?" We know that answer. That makes this even harder. You see, those who do not seek justice, who do not do the things that we just read, those are the wicked. We are the wicked because we don't do those things as often as we ought. We are guilty of injustice. And because we're guilty of injustice, those words that Amos spoke in today's reading should sting. Should be a reminder that when we are sitting in our pews, when we are offering our prayers, when we are offering our offerings, how is God receiving those things? I mean, let's be honest, we can never fully obtain it, but are we at least trying? Are we at least attempting? Are we living in response to the righteousness and justice and mercy and peace and love and grace that we have been given through this cross of Jesus Christ? Because of that cross, because of that gift that we have been given through Jesus, who gives us his righteousness, who on that cross died for our sins and therefore restoring us into right relationship. Because of that, we are called to seek justice, to love our neighbor as ourselves. Remember, Jesus picks up similar themes when he talks about whatever you have done to the least of these. What are those things he lifts off, right? Sounds very familiar to what I read earlier. He talks about being hungry. He talks about being thirsty. He talks about being the stranger. He talks about being sick. He talks about being in prison, being captive. And that captivity can be to many things. So if we are called to justice, what does that mean? How should we live our life? Justice for us, I think, means courageously, even when our voices are trembling, stepping up, and as Jeremiah says, speaking out for those that cannot speak. In other words, courageously making problems that others are dealing with my own problem. Because if they're the image of God, I'm the image of God, I have been given grace, peace, mercy, and love through this cross. When someone suffers, I suffer. So I must courageously stand up, even when my voice trembles, and speak out against injustice, speak out against oppression, speak out against those systems, those things, those whatevers that keeps us from being on a level ground. And when we at least attempt to do that, I do believe that God welcomes our songs. God welcomes our offerings. God welcomes our praise. When we try to do our part to let justice flow, to be a part of that flow of justice throughout this world, I think God smiles. Even when we fail and fall on our face, we're at least trying. We're at least living in the response that we, in response to that, that we have been given. And that's a hard truth. It's a hard reality. But I think it's something we need to sit with. Amen.
Let us pray. O God of justice and love, you illumine our way through life with the words of your Son. Give us the light we need and awaken us to the needs of others. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Longing for Christ's reign to come among us, we pray for the outpouring of God's power on the church, the world, and all in need. Holy God, rouse us to deep praise as we gather for worship. Enliven our worship with sincere and heartfelt song. Sustain the work of all church musicians and artists who lead us in praise and prayer. We especially give thanks for Jody, Randy, and Carol. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Holy Creator, surprise and delight us with the beauty of the world you have made. Bless the work of landscapers, architects, and artists, whose work invites us into harmonious living with your creation. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Holy Judge, let justice roll down like waters over this world. Reign over the courtrooms of every land. In the hearts of those who guard the law and those who stand accused of crimes, be present in cases where we long for both justice and mercy to prevail. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Holy Companion, console those who feel lonely or abandoned. Share the hours of those who live and eat alone. Comfort those who have few friends or who struggle with their identity and place in this world. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Holy Protector, be with all observing Veterans Day. Guard the lives of active duty and retired military personnel. Comfort all who mourn those who have died in the line of duty. Heal the wounds, both physical and mental, experienced by service members. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Holy and immortal One, we pray in thanksgiving for the lives of all who have died. Remind us of the frailty and shortness of our own lives and inspire us to use them for the building up of your kingdom. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Receive our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, until that day when you gather all of creation around your throne, where you will reign forever
and ever. Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and also with you.
We continue our service with the giving of our tithes and offerings. We give thanks for those that have been able to continue to support the ministries of St. Paul's and Bethany Lutheran Churches. Let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, maker of all things. You have set before us these gifts of your good creation. Prepare us for your heavenly banquet. Nourish us with this rich food and drink, and send us forth to set tables in the midst of a suffering world. Through the bread of life, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Let us pray as our Lord and Savior Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Then thy new creation, pure. us, let us be. Let us see thy great salvation perfectly restored in thee, changed from glory into glory till in heaven we take our place, till we cast our crowns before thee, lost in wonder, love, and praise.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Friends, go forth into the world to serve God with gladness. Be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honor all people. Love and serve God, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And let the church say, thanks be to God.
Go in peace, love and serve our God and our neighbor. Thanks be to God, and we will.